Welcome to the optical modeling part of this course. In the coming lectures, we will talk about the various aspects of optical modeling of photovoltaic devices. We start by asking the question, what is the optical modeling of PV devices? With the term optical modeling, we indicate the series of steps necessary to model the optical performance of a solar cell. This performance is normally quantified by the absorption, reflection, and transmission in all layers of the solar cells. These three quantities allow to determine the useful absorption in the active layer of the device and the optical losses expressed by reflection and transmission of the device and by parasitic absorption in the supporting layers. In the slides, you can see the example of absorption in all layers of a tandem device of solar cell. Several quantities can be determined from the results. First, as depicted in the graph, the implied photocurrent density generated in all active layers in the device, indicated with the letter J. This quantity indicates the maximum current density that can be generated in the active layers. This assumes that all absorbed photons generated a whole electron pair and that all holes and electrons are collected. Then, information about absorption in the active layer can be converted into the generation rate of charge carriers, indicated with G. This quantity is of great importance, since it is one of the fundamental input parameters for electrical simulations, as explained later in the course. Depending on the selected modeling approach, this parameter, G, is determined only as a function of the depth within the device, hence as a function of only one dimension, or as a function of the exact three-dimensional position inside the solar cell. An accurate optical modeling depends on the correct properties determined during the characterization. In particular, the use of correctly measured refractive index values is fundamental for every layer of the solar cell. In addition, a correct characterization of the device morphology is crucial to build up an accurate solar cell model. Finally, the measured device performance can be used to calibrate the chosen simulation platform and ensure that the obtained results can be trusted. Several methods are available to model the optical performance of photovoltaic devices. First, they can be divided by the domain in which equations are solved. In frequency domain approaches, the material optical properties are defined as a function of the frequency of light, hence as a function of wavelength. Equations are then solved for every wavelength in the specified range and at every point in the defined structure. On the other hand, time domain approaches can resolve equations for a wide frequency range in a single simulation at every point in the solar cell model. However, the optical properties of every material are measured as a function of wavelength. As such, they need to be fitted with specific function depending on the type of material used. The fitting of some materials is more challenging than for the others, as it will be explained. For this reason, in some cases, it might not be convenient to use time domain approaches. The selection of the appropriate modeling tool also depends on the dimension of the modeled device and textures. When very thin layers are used, or textures with the sides smaller than the wavelength of light in the material, we must use a method that is able to deal with the wave optics. This means that the software needs to be able to model complex optical phenomena like diffraction and interference. On the other hand, when only thick layers and textures with the large fissures are included, methods that can only deal with the geometrical optics, by which we mean refraction, are sufficient to accurately characterize the optical performance of a photovoltaic device. A final distinction can be made between rigorous and non-rigorous methods. Rigorous methods include all methods that obtain their solution by calculating the electromagnetic field inside the solar cell. This is usually achieved by solving Maxwell equations within the device volume. Several methods are available and will be described in the following lectures, including a finite difference time domain, or FDTD, the finite element method, abbreviated to FEM, and the rigorous coupled wave analysis, or RCWA. On the other hand, non-rigorous approaches do not compute the intensity of the electromagnetic field inside the device. Rather, they rely on equations and models that describe the propagation of light in different conditions. For example, Lambert's Beer's law is used to describe absorption in a thick uniform layer, or the scalar scattering theory is employed to model the interaction of light with small random textures. These approaches aim at making the problem to solve simpler, but can be as accurate as rigorous methods if properly applied. Several methods have been developed throughout the years, including the GEMPRO software here in Delft, the Optos platform developed at Fraunhofer ISE, or the Chrome suite by the University of Ljubljana, and many others. In the following lectures, both rigorous and non-rigorous methods will be introduced, and you will have the chance to improve your optical modeling proficiency by using the fourth version of our in-house developed GEMPRO software.